Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Speaking about Salaah Ad-Duha, we know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not omit this prayer while being on a travel, even though while being resident. Therefore, he would not leave this prayer out. This shows you that this Salah is a confirmed sunnah. What is Salaah Ad-Duha? Ad-Duha means from sunrise till Zawal. This is called Duha. Salat al-Duha is the prayer that is prayed between the sunrise until Zawal. Sunrise means the sun has risen. Zawal means when the sun has reached its zenith, the meridian. So it is a prayer that is prayed between this time. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam indicated that this prayer, it is better to be prayed hina tarmadu al-fisal, when, you know, the camel feet start feeling the heat, which means when the time it gets very hot. For this is the best time to pray Salah al-Duha. So the earliest time to pray Salah al-Duha is once the sun has risen. 15 minutes after that, then you can pray that Salah. And some people, they call that Salah, Salat al-Sharaq, or Salat al-Awabin, or Salat al-Duha, or some people call it the Chasht Namaz. And the description of the Salah is a normal 2 raka'ah of prayer, or 4 raka'ah, or 6 or 8. I'm going to explain inshaAllah. You read whatever you want in the first, second raka'ah, and then you make taslim. This is the way of praying Salat al-Duha, very simple and light, the way the Prophet Muhammad would do. The number of raka'ah is, you can pray from 2 raka'ah, or you can pray 4 raka'ah, or you can pray 6 raka'ah, you can pray 8 raka'ah, MashaAllah, until how much you want. But the Prophet Muhammad sallam, it indicated in hadith, he asked us to pray 2, or we pray 4, or the Prophet himself prayed 8 raka'ah, which we're going to speak inshaAllah. What are the virtues of praying Salah al-Duha? First of all, we know that we have 360 joints in our body. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, we had to give sadaqah on each and every joint of our body every day. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, in the morning, every single joint of yours must pay sadaqah. Every subhanallah is sadaqah, every alhamdulillah is sadaqah, every la ilaha illallah is sadaqah, every Allahu Akbar is sadaqah, every commanding the good is sadaqah, every forbidding the good is sadaqah. Therefore, you've been thinking, how am I going to give 360 sadaqah for my joints? And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, and all that accomplish all these is praying 2 raka'ah of Salat al-Duha. Allahu Akbar. So if you pray 2 raka'ah of Salat al-Duha, it encompasses all what I just mentioned now. That means you have done your duty of the day for giving 360 sadaqah for each and every joints you have. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, none is diligent in establishing Salat al-Duha except those who are awab, those who are of repentant. And it is a prayer for those who repent. Therefore, it is a sign if you want to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, hafiz, keep on doing this prayer, and it shows these are the sign of people who repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. That is why it is called Salah al-Awabin as well, the Salah of those who repented to Allah Azza wa Jal. And it is an advice given to Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said that my friend, the Prophet sallam, advised me to do 3 things. Number 1, to fast 3 days in a month. Number 2, to pray 2 raka'ah of Salat al-Duha. And number 3, to pray witr before going to bed. So Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said, I did not, once hearing this, I will not stop the 3 advices until I die. But it shows you over here that 2 raka'ah is the minimum. And speaking about forgiveness of the sin, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever regularly prays 2 raka'ah of duha, his sin are forgiven, even though they are like the vastness of the foam of the sea. Subhanallah. Where are we? Why haven't we been praying this prayer all this time? For it tells you that it is a prayer that it's good that we prayed. It is not fard, but it is then a confirmed sunnah. And we know that we are into issues every day. The Prophet ﷺ said that Allah Azza wa Jal said, O son of Adam, do not be heedless, do not neglect the four raka'at of al-duha at the beginning of the day. If you do so, then I shall be your sufficiency at its end. Which means that whoever prays four raka'ah of Salat al-Duha at the beginning of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of all his affairs. Yeah, so now this hadith tells us that we can pray four raka'at as well bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So the number of raka'at we say according to the virtues, you can pray two minimum, you can pray four, you can pray eight. Like Umhani radiallahu anha, she said on the day of the opening of the of Mecca, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prayed eight raka'ah of Salatul Duha, which means that if you're going to pray more than two, you make two, then you make taslim, another two raka'ah, make taslim, another two raka'ah, make taslim. This is it. We don't do all together, we do two raka'ah, mathna, mathna, two by two. And this is something that, brothers and sisters, that we need to put into practice. Yes, like how I said last time, we do pray five daily prayers. And we want to do that extra deeds to get near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the extra deeds that we may do. You know, after Salatul Fajr, you've gone back home, you started your work. And then from Fajr until Dhuhr, it's a long time. And in between, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put that prayer. Yeah, which is not fard. So in order not to get you too indulged into the dunya, come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same thing between Isha and Fajr. It's a long time that you cut from the fard prayer. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put tahajjud, so you don't cut. You know, you don't get yourself involved in the dunya too much. So these are the prayers that when you do, you get near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let's put into a practice from today that inshallah, I am going to start doing my Salatul Duha, inshallah. When does it start? It starts 15 minutes after the sun has risen until 20 minutes before Adhan of Dhuhr. Anytime you can pray during these periods, inshallah. Until then, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.